Dear students, please think and reflect. If the shrunken vegetables kept in water, they become swollen or fresh. What is the reason? Think about it. You will get the answer for that question through this lesson. Osmosis occurs through egg membrane. In this lesson, the learner going to learn that conducts activity to remove egg membrane from egg and perform the osmosis experiment with the egg membrane, explains the process of osmosis, identifies the difference between exo and endo osmosis. To get all those learning outcomes, you have to observe this experiment, that is osmosis experiment with egg membrane. Materials required are eggs, hydrochloric acid, beakers, salt solution, tap water, needle, plates. Here my students are performing the experiment, that is osmosis with the egg membrane. First, what we have to do, we have to remove the egg membrane from eggs. For that we required two raw eggs, beakers, they have water, hydrochloric acid, that is concentrated one, and the dropper. To remove eggshell, we have to keep the eggs in water. Directly don't take the concentrated hydrochloric acid in the beakers. That acid may harm your fingers. So first keep the water in beaker, add egg to it, and later add the concentrated hydrochloric acid to water. Like this way. If you don't have hydrochloric acid with you, you can use bathroom cleaning acid also. That acid also removes the eggshell. Eggshell is made up of calcium carbonate. That is dissolving in HCl. You can observe that. See here how the eggshell is dissolving in HCl. We have to keep these eggs in hydrochloric acid for 5 hours. Complete eggshell should be removed completely. Once completely eggshell is removed, you are observing the eggs without shells. They are looking like balls and flexible they are. Now what we have to do, we have to take out the inner part or visceral part of that egg. So for that we have to make a hole on the egg like this and take out the material very gently, otherwise the membrane will break. See the visceral part of that egg. Yeah, finally we got the egg membrane. That is the egg membrane. What we have to do? We have to clean that. We have to pour the water inside that egg membrane and clean it properly. And again, what I am doing here, clearing the second one egg inside inside part is removing. We have to wash those two egg membranes with the water. Now they are ready to do the osmosis experiment. That means we washed them properly. To perform osmosis experiment, what we have to do? We have to fill these two egg membranes with the water. One with the concentrated water and another one is just drinking water. For that, I added 2 tablespoons of salt to the first beaker. That means this is salt water and this is fresh water. First, I am pouring the salt water in first egg membrane with the help of a dropper. You can use pipette or syringe to fill that egg membrane. Okay. What we are filling in it? Salt, water. You can fill 10 ml or 15 ml up to. After that, we have to close the mouth of that egg membrane pouch with a fine thread. Yeah. Now you are watching how to tie that egg membrane sac. Make sure the water inside the egg pouch should not leave. So we have to make a knot with the thread. And later we have to keep this salt watered egg pouch in fresh water beaker. So beaker has fresh water in it. We kept the salt water egg pouch in it. Okay. Now what we have to do? We have to take a second egg membrane. The beaker has 150 ml water in it and the pouch has 10 ml water. Second egg membrane. In first egg membrane, we poured salt water. Here I am taking the fresh water. How much amount of water we have to take here? Same amount, 10 ml. If we take 15 ml in first membrane, we have to take 15 ml. If we take 10 ml, here also 10 ml. I am pouring water in second egg membrane. Yeah. What we have to do? We have to tie that egg membrane with the thread. And keep that fresh water egg membrane pouch in salt water beaker with salt water. Okay. Yeah. This beaker contains fresh water, but egg pouch has salt water. This beaker has salt water and the egg pouch kept in it as fresh water. 2 beakers has equal amounts of water, 150 ml. 2 pouches, egg pouches has equal amounts of water. Now we will see what will happen after 5-6 hours. But we observed these two next day morning. See what happened? the egg membrane which is kept in fresh water, the pouch becomes swollen somewhat. That means water moved from beaker to egg pouch. What happens in osmosis? From lower concentration to higher concentration, molecules move. If you see here, the pouch is shrunken here, because the water present in the egg membrane moved into beaker. So that is why here water moved from egg membrane to beaker. So the egg membrane was shrunken. The second beaker also, water moved from lower concentration to higher concentration. So what happened in the first beaker? Water moved from beaker to egg membrane. That is, water moved into cells. Here, endoosmosis occurred. What happened here? From cells inside the pouch to water moves outside. So that means exoosmosis occurred here. I told you first question, at the time first I asked you one question. How shrunken vegetables get swollen when kept in water? That means water moved into vegetables or water moved out of vegetables? Water moved into vegetables. That is why they become swollen. That means what happened there? Endoosmosis or exoosmosis? Endoosmosis occurred. Okay. Now I want to sum up that endo and exoosmosis again. The process in which water molecules leave the egg membrane or cell is called exoosmosis. The process in which water molecules enter the egg membrane or cell is called endoosmosis. Okay, children, answer these questions and send the answers to your teachers. Okay, explain the process that how to prepare egg membrane. Write the procedure to be followed in the materials required to conduct exoosmosis and endoosmosis with egg membrane. What is the difference between exoosmosis and endoosmosis? Okay, children, don't forget to write answers. Thanks for watching. I will meet you again with another topic. Until then, bye.